speaker today is the President and CEO of Millennium Consulting, a successful marketing company renowned for the shock and awe package. It's a popular marketing method for landing an appointment with a qualified prospect, for getting in front of the customer. Pat began his entrepreneurial career with the purchase of his first business in 1988, a quick copy, like Quick Trip, KWIK, printing franchise. He then acquired Postmark, a mailing company, to complement his printing business. With the ability to design, print, fulfill, and mail materials from one location, clients were able to consolidate and streamline their printing and marketing processes. With an extensive background in sales, marketing, and business, Pat brings a very practical approach to what he does. He's continually testing marketing methods that are effective in his business before he suggests implementing them for his clients. I like that. Proven. Specialties. Millennium produces customized marketing and prospecting systems which help the small business owner produce a consistent message to prospects and current clients. A small business can support a sales staff without having to add marketing personnel. Have you thanked your customers lately? Thank you to my knitter here. Millennium has created a thank you package, a thank you and rewards / loyalty system to fulfill this missing gap. Please help me welcome our speaker, Pat Pendergast.
Thank you. Thank you, Keith. I want to thank Maggie for having me come today. She's kind of like my mentor. And if you can use her for anything, please do, because she's really helpful. And she gives you the support you need, so I want to thank her for that. And she's awesome. That's right. So I'm an author and entrepreneur. I'm a small business owner, just like all of you probably here. My first business I started when I was 26 years old. And actually, it goes back even further when I had my own first paper route. So that's when I learned how to do collections, run from dogs. And I actually had to do, that was my first sales job that I ever had, which I didn't realize it, but at the time we would go out in a van full of young kids back in the old days, and the manager would send us out to knock on doors to get to sell subscriptions. And then the other thing that I want to share with you, I was also learning how to collect receivables by having to knock on the door to get people to pay me for the newspapers every week. And it was funny because some people would leave their money out in a little chain. Back then, it was only pennies for a newspaper. They'd leave in a little dish. And some people would avoid me. So I was learning real quickly what it's like to ask for my money. So that's something, as a small business owner, we all need to know. I have a little tagline. It's people, process, persistence. We forget about the people. We've got to remember that people, customers are people. And we have to remember that. So that's why it's so important to me. We have to treat them like people. And even business to business, you are selling to people. So remember that. There's a person behind that. Process, it's very important to have a process and a system. And I'm going to show you a system that I use today that's something that you can use. But this is something that's actually in place and getting used today that's making money. Persistence and making money. Persistence and whoever is in sales here, which most of us probably are, we know we have to be persistent. So it's very important. And I received a compliment the other day from somebody, and he said that one thing I like about you, Pat, is that you never give up. And that's true. And I've taught my kids that, my family that. So that's something that you got to remember, that if you have kids, you pass that along to them just by what you do and how you act around your house. I'm also the creator of the Shock and Awe package, which is something I created. I wanted to create something that was something unusual, but it was very effective. So I'm going to show you today how you can use a Shock and Awe package to sell the appointment. That's what's important here, is we're selling an appointment. Because that's what we got to do, is we got to get someone to raise their hand and say, I'll listen to you, I'll talk to you. So I want to show you today how I can help you break down that door. And then the last thing, and I was talking with Rob today, and I'm glad I got to sit next to him, because he's also in marketing and we could kind of talk shop. But I told him that I pivoted, and the reason why I pivoted, and I'll share that with you right now, is that I was casting a net to small businesses. I was a consultant to small businesses. How big is that net? It's pretty large. So I wasn't standing out in the crowd. I really wasn't. Even though my shock and awe package was effective, I couldn't stand out in the crowd. So what I decided to do is I pivoted, taking the same model that I was using, and I just niched. So right now I'm selling to dentists. And I'll show you today how that is working for me and how we're making money doing it. So, but everything I'm doing today, or everything I'm showing you today, you can do for yourself. It's very simple and easy to use. So I want to make sure that it's not about me. It's about what you guys can take away from today. Lucas, he gave us a ton of stuff. It's just amazing. I mean, whew, is really good, you guys. If you can just walk away with one or two things, I think it's going to be really effective. For me, I'm going to give you just one or two things that I just want you to walk away with today, because that's really all you need, because Lucas gave you a ton of stuff that's going to really work well for all of you. Anybody, I'm sure you recognize those people up there. Up on the left is Seth Gooden. He's a blogger, he's a marketer, he sells books, he's very good. We got Tim Ferriss, 4-Hour Workweek. And we got Marcus Lemonis on the left. And then we got Gary Vaynerchuk on the right. Exactly. Most of you guys know these people, and they're very good at what they do. I follow, and I encourage every one of you here to follow Seth Gooden. Now, he sends an email once a day. Sounds like a lot until you realize what he's writing makes a lot of sense. And Lucas, that guy ties right into what Lucas was talking about today as to how many times a day you're tweeting, a week, and so on. So what I do is these are the big four that I follow. Seth is really good because all of a sudden what Lucas was telling you makes sense. You're like, wow, he's doing it. The other thing is, though, is have good content, which Seth has really good stuff. Tim Ferriss, I don't follow on his newsletter so much or his email list, but we all know about him. I actually follow him on Instagram. Really cool. I would encourage you to follow him just because you can kind of see what kind of techniques he uses. And he's really out there. He talks about his dog. I mean, just kind of stuff like that that it kind of people can relate to. Marcus Lemonis, most everybody know him. The Prophet on CNBC. The guy's a genius when it comes to talking to small businesses. Mostly retail, so I don't know if anybody here works in retail, but I deal business to business, and you can relate a lot to what he does. And last but not least is Gary Vee. If there's only one person you're going to follow, follow him. And he's like drinking from a fire hose. Okay, but he taught me something very important. I'm listening to his current book on audio presentation, and he made a comment that stuck to me, and he says a lot of stuff. He drops a lot of F-bombs, so if you're not into that, don't listen to him. But anyway, 300 million ways to win in the United States, don't do it like them. And when he means them, these are the one percenters. These are the guys that have figured out how to be multimillionaires doing social media. So he said, don't do it like them, do it like you. Because remember, and Lucas can probably agree with this, is it's about your personality. Maggie could too. It's about personality. People buy personalities. So you're not going to be successful. I think Lucas even mentioned it today. He says, you know, it's not about how many followers you have. You don't want to be upside down. It's about you. So I just wanted, and it was perfect that Lucas was here. I didn't put two and two together. It must have been in the back of my mind to put this here, knowing Lucas was going to be talking about social media to you today. So it's important to do it like you. That's what sets you apart and why people are going to buy from you. And the one thing that I'm sure Lucas didn't get a chance to talk about is, and I'm big on, is converting. Okay, we want to convert those lists, those people, to buyers. So you're talking to a guy that's about making money here, and I don't want anybody to starve. I want people to be successful. So when you deal with me, it's about ROI. Let's make some money doing it. I'm going to show you a shock and awe package today that was a very successful program run for somebody that I met at Million Cups. Has anybody heard of Million Cups? And the one gentleman I knew was here, he left. Million Cups, and I'm going to throw out there that I encourage you to come. It's on Wednesdays, 9 to 10 for 1 hour only. Startups give a pitch for 20 minutes. And the audience just gives suggestions. It's not like Shark Tank. It's not adversarial. It's about And if you guys want to make a pitch and you're starting a business, I encourage it. But it's about going there and perfecting your pitch if you're going to investors or something like that. So anyway, after I met this Project Foundry owners, I sent them a shock and awe package, just like this. I sent them a box in the mail. Okay, this came, and I'm going to give you a little secret today about how to save money with FedEx. Use FedEx Ground. Okay, there's your money-saving tip of the day. FedEx Ground gets there just as fast, unless, of course, you want it overnight. But trust me, anywhere in southeast Wisconsin, it gets there the next day. A box like this ships for probably anywhere from $7 to $10. But the perception is, when a FedEx guy brings a box, what do? You want to open it. Okay, so it's all about perception, and it's about marketing. And Rob hopefully will shake his head and nod his head that he agrees with that. But so you don't have to spend a ton of money to get the perception of this is important, you need to open this. So that's part of the whole shock and awe package. What's inside is really just, I'm going to say it's a pop propaganda, but it's about all I'm trying to do is get someone to say, you know what, this guy's got something to say, I'm interested, I'm going to take his phone call. So all I'm doing with a shock and awe package is selling the appointment. Now, let me give you the example of success. This is the shock and awe package that I developed for Project Foundry. The funny thing about the package that I sent him, it sat on his desk for 3 months. And let me tell you, I followed up with phone calls. I did everything right. But it wasn't on my time, it was on his time. So 3 months later, I got an email, Pat, I really liked your shock and awe package. Come on in, let's talk about it. Okay? It just told me that sometimes my sales process is 3 months. Which it was. So his idea, he loved the shock and awe package. He needed to raise $250,000 from a group of investors to finish what they call their seed round. So he had already raised $1 million. He needed $250,000 more. And we were only going to send that to 25 people. So 25 people got this shock and awe package. Now, what he was selling was a phone call. So let me just tell you a little bit about this. Okay, you get a box in the mail, FedEx, and it was local, it was southeast Wisconsin. They're going to open it. A couple things. The people that he was sending to knew of him, so they're getting a package that they knew from someone they recognized. Now, here's the funny thing about people and things they love, and I'm sorry I don't have it with me. We had a T-shirt in there. People love T-shirts. These are millionaires. These are millionaires that love T-shirts. So there was a T-shirt in here, a book. Okay, the book, all this book did was mention Project Foundry in it. Okay, and what it did, it was just gave them credibility of their business. He also put a pen in there and a T-shirt. And I'm sorry I don't have the T-shirt, but trust me, people like to get stuff. So the letter, what we did then is that he also just had gotten a write-up in the business journal. So we put something together, we put a letter, and his letter, even though it's rather long, all it did was ask for a phone call. I'm going to call you in a week, and we're going to talk about how I'm going to help me raise $250,000. 2 weeks ago, this came out in the Biz Times. Now, I hadn't talked to Bill Mortimer lately. He hadn't given me the update, so this was as much a surprise and to me was that they raised the $250,000 that they needed. It took them 3 months. He used the shock and awe package. What it did is allowed him an introduction to a phone call. And then he went to sell it. So that's the one thing that here, the shock and awe package is not meant to sell or close a deal. It's meant to get a phone call. So did anybody have any questions so far? I'm going pretty fast. I don't want to. Okay. The thing to remember about a shock and awe package, yes?
Is this the way to get past the gatekeeper?
I'm glad you brought that up, because the thing I forgot to mention was you need to get to the influencer, okay? So what happened is when I sent mine, I knew who the influencer was or the actual buyer. And how many of us have tried to call and call and call and found out it was the wrong person? Trust me, I've done it, and I try not to do it anymore. But you got to get to the influencer, because if you try to sell this just to the front counter person, you're not going to get anywhere. They're just going to push it off. So that's important. Now, when the Project Foundry sent this, he knew exactly who he was going to. He was going to investors who had actually written a check in the past, either to him or someone else. So he knew they had money. Actually, they were qualified investors. So that's the key. He knew that he would get an answer and a decision. Now, this is my current one. I was mentioning to you that I'm now selling to dentists. I'm marketing to dentists. This is the one I'm doing currently that will go to a dentist. Now, this goes not to the office manager. It will go to the dentist, because the dentist is a decision maker. However, the office manager gets the mail, and they sort the mail, and they throw the mail out. Now, if a box comes, and I found this out the hard way, and I encourage you, here's another method. These are the other envelopes I use. I was using these kind of envelopes to sell to dentists, but I could never get past the office manager because she would throw these away. So I had to outthink her. I'm sorry, it's traditionally a woman, but I had to outthink her, and I did. I sent a box to them, FedEx. And the dentist does not ignore a FedEx box. So that is, and like I said, it's rather inexpensive, unless, of course, it's time. To send to the East Coast, you know, it's only like $12. So it's not too big or too bad of an investment. And last but not least, I'm going to give you the ultimate box. This is the shock and awe package that was actually something I received after investing with a person, a significant amount of money. And I'm still with this gentleman today. But trust me, there is hundreds of dollars worth of stuff, and there's a $2 bill in here. I mean, the guy just went over. This is worth, probably cost him a couple hundred dollars to do. But when I got it, and trust me, I've seen a lot of stuff. When I got that knocked my socks off. I'm like, wow, this guy is serious. So I knew that, one, my investment with him was real and for sure, that he was serious. So think about that. A shock and awe package can also be used as a follow-up to a new client. And that's why I said, what have you done for your clients lately? Have you written a thank you? Have you sent them something in the mail? And I encourage you to do that today. Write a little thank you to one of your current clients. Now, what I want to talk to you today about is real things going on. This is something that I'm doing right now. This is a campaign I'm running. And I wanted to show you the numbers, and I'm being very transparent with this because you guys need to hear it. You need to know that truly somebody is doing something and making it work, and I am doing that. I'm not bragging about it. I just want to share it with you because you guys can easily do something like this too. Ideal Patient Systems is the current company, which I just started about 3 months ago. And we put together, we bought a mailing list, an email list of dentists that we tried many times, and we called it a cold list. We were trying to sell consulting to it. Nothing was happening. So we decided that, you know what, we need to sell, we're going to try marketing. So what we did is we sent to 18,500 people an email link to view a teleseminar on a certain night at a certain time. You have to be bold. You have to say, you have to put the stake in the ground and say, this is what time it's going to be and when it's going to be there. We had 15 people show up for the teleseminar, okay? And it was interesting. It was really weird, and this might happen to you, and I hope it does someday. We only had eight or nine, and the minute the teleseminar started, we had five just jump in. So, and I think, you know, Maggie can probably attest to this, that sometimes people wait to the last minute. So don't, you know, if you're like wondering, no one's showing up or whatever, just trust the process, trust the system, and do it. 18,000 people got an email. 18,000 got an email. And how many deletes did we get? A lot, trust me. However, but you got to remember now, and I'm sorry, when we work through the math, you're going to understand why it works. 15 people showed up to watch me, listen to me talk to somebody. I was interviewed by another gentleman. They listened for 45 minutes. They stayed on the whole time, which surprised me. It really did. I was really shocked because I was the first time doing it and didn't know what to expect. I had five people at the end of the teleseminar. We had a website landing page to go to, asking them to fill out a information if they're interested in a marketing assessment. I had 5 people fill out an assessment, which shocked me again. So I'm just telling you, it works. And they gave me their name, address, phone number, most of them were cell numbers, and email addresses. So I mean, trust me, people will do this. I sent out 5 shock and awe packages. And inside the box was the program that I was promoting to them. And of the 5 shock and awe packages, I closed 1, which was worth $12,000. First year value. Now, as of yesterday, I closed another one yesterday. Thank you. But let me, and it gets me excited, and I really appreciate that, except now that number went to 45,000. Okay? Now, trust me, I'm not bragging here, but I'm just showing you why, when you put the numbers together and when you're marketing to the right people, this one, first number was to, I had 3 different types of programs you could buy. This guy here bought the bottom one, only because he could afford the bottom one, and trust me, when we get his program working, he's going to be moved up. But this next one I sold yesterday took the middle one, which obviously then the number ran like that. Now, I want to share with you too that everything I do is continuity. Continuity meaning that if you sign up with me, it's for the year. Every year, every month, we're going to send out a direct mail piece for you, and we're going to hit your credit card for it. So it's continuity. So sell them once, it keeps coming every month. So I encourage that. Anytime you can do continuity, and we can all think of continuity by Amazon Prime, Netflix. So trust me, we're all subjected right now to continuity. We may not know it or you may know it. So this is how the money-making math works for this program. Reason why is because the reason why we can afford to spend the money on the email list and so on is because the value of our program is worth $12,000 to $45,000. Okay, so if you know your lifetime value of a client, that can help you budget. And you know what? It also is going to show you that you can budget more than you thought. It really can. This kind of program does not work selling $1 widgets. I'm sorry, it doesn't. But I don't think people here are selling $1 widgets. So it works on your programs. It really does. And those numbers that are here, I share them with you only because you can kind of relate, but don't make it a negative. It's a positive, because I can take your numbers and we can make them work too. Now, emails work with this dental group. Now I'm going to show you another one. Don't forget to give me my time. This is a bigger number, but I'm just showing you how the numbers work. This is the other side of the business that I am partnering with. But this is actually doing direct mail. This is actually sending out 35,000 direct mail pieces a month. It's a number 10 envelope with 3 sheets of paper inside it. It's big numbers. Every week, actually, this is how detailed we are. We mail it out on a Thursday, Friday, to make sure it hits the dentist on a Tuesday or Wednesday. Because dentists tend to be off on, they tend to be off on Fridays, but they're usually in on Wednesdays, so we want that mailing to hit on a Wednesday. It's extremely important that we found out that it's got to hit on a Wednesday. So out of the 35,000 direct mail pieces, we're going to get 160 requests for a book, which is actually a shock and awe package. Okay, so now, of those, we'll get 90 phone calls that people will say, okay, we'll take a phone call from you. But trust me, of the 90 phone calls, we only get 20 conversations. So that's how many drop. That's how quickly this drops. So that's one thing, is that it's strictly a numbers game here. But we've tested this. We've done this now for 6 months, and these numbers, they work. And they truly come out. 5 new clients will generate a month out of this whole system and this program. So this is truly working right now. Now, not everybody can afford this, and trust me, this was not how it was started. It started small. But we worked our way up to it. Rob?
I'm looking at the numbers. Is that $150,000 net or gross?
Gross.
So it doesn't include the cost of the direct mail pieces?
Oh, I'm sorry. Continue. No, it does not include the budget. That's for 1 month, Rob.
Gotcha.
Yep, that's 1 month.
Rob, $50,000 a month. Why are you here instead of, you know, on your airplane somewhere? On
yeah. Because remember, I said one thing you might have noticed when I said Rob asked me why I'm here because the number's so big. But trust me, I'm a little partner with this group. Okay. That's why. I'm not getting all those rewards. That's feeding many people. But trust me, the math works on this really well because the guy that owns this, his goal is an airplane in 3 years. Okay? There's a lot of work that's been done here to make these numbers work. And Rob's shaking his head or nodding saying, yes, but these do work. The thing is this is already scaled up. Okay, this is not where, you know, like a lot of us here have to start from with much smaller numbers, but that's okay because like Lucas today showed you how to get how many followers. All we need to do is convert those people. Okay, so you've been given many ways to generate leads, and I've given you a way to convert a lead. And that's what's really important. And I talked to Trish or Patricia. And we were talking earlier today about she's in real estate, and I encouraged her to listen to Gary V. Vaynerchuk because he mentioned in one of his talks that if you're in real estate, you should be. And he's big on social, so he had the answers. And forgive me, I don't have the exact answer, but he said I can get you if you do it correctly. A real estate agent can get. And when they find out that somebody's searching in your neighborhood, or you can be promoting a restaurant, and oh, by the way, I noticed you're shopping here, did you go to this restaurant, or something like that. Social media works that way. But I would encourage her to go to Gary V, listen to his podcast, and he's going to give her the answer that she needs to make social media work for her and how to convert. So I'm a big proponent of converting. Lucas. Okay, this is the direct mail pieces, so these are mailing lists. The other list was a purchased email list. There are a couple, I'm going to call them gurus. Lucas asked where I'm getting these mailing lists or email lists. And we can purchase from, right now we're going to launch, we're going to mail out or send out an email blast to 6,000. Dental Town is a magazine that sells print and also online ads. These are opted-in dentists. So we're paying for these dental clients that have shown a tendency to buy online. Does that make sense?
Yeah, fine. I've just gotten into I pushed the envelope.
Sure.
All the time.
And you should.
I got kicked off of MailChimp in one of my emails because I uploaded from my Gmail account.
Correct. Yes. That's a fantastic question, Lucas, because what happens is that with Dental Town, they will not give us the list. So in other words, they own the list. They own the list. Okay? So no, we give them money and say, send, and we give them the copy, though, so they allow us to get the copy. Now, you can buy a list from InfoUSA, and InfoUSA is really good stuff. But InfoUSA, last time I talked to them, and I think as frustrating it is for marketers like us, they will require you to send the copy, they approve the copy, and they retain the list. They will do the sending. That's how it keeps it from being spammed. And those are called opt-in lists. Those are the best lists to get. In other words, an opt-in list is a list that someone has shown a propensity to say, I buy online. Okay? And trust me, the emails you've gotten in the past, you are on somebody's list that you opted in at one time, and someone has either sold that list or whatever. Now, trust me, how many times have we bought from Amazon and gotten, I mean, I get emails every day from Amazon telling me what some ideas I should buy something, right? And boy, are they smart. So anyway, that's database management. But that's a great question. You have to be, I would never encourage anybody here to do what Lucas did, because you'll get blacklisted. Last thing you want to do is get your website blacklisted. You're in deep trouble then. And that's a great...
Good email.
Yeah. Except it was the wrong way to do it. And MailChimp is tough on that, too. You know, so, and they rightly so. And Lucas said, good for you. Because, trust me, we all need to push the envelope. Don't be afraid to push it. Like Lucas did it, all he knew is MailChimp's going to slap his hand, right? And that's all who's going to salute. Now, if you were toying with Google, it'd be a different story. But MailChimp, that's just the rules, the way it is. Trust me, he's probably 1 in 1,000 that today already tried that. And MailChimp has cut him off. But MailChimp has to retain their credibility, and they're the gatekeepers. So the list that we're getting for Dentaltown that we're going to do next month, next month is owned by them. We give them the copy, and they send it out. So, and trust me, we have to trust them they send it, which they will. So, but it's big money. Real quick, market stamina. You need to stay in the game, okay? Don't give up. That's what I'm saying here. Stay in the game. Pivot if you have to. And when I say pivot, what I did is I noticed that my net was too big going to small businesses, and then I narrowed it to dentists, and all of a sudden my numbers work now. So narrow your focus, pivot if you have to, and don't be afraid to pivot. I'm 54. I pivoted. That's a 20-year-old, 25-year-old person doing a pivot like that. But you know what? We can all do it at any age. The 10,000-hour rule, I'm going to kind of shoot a hole in it. You don't get benefits from mechanical repetition. If you're a pianist, the 10,000 rule applies. But does anybody run that number once? 7 years at 4 hours a day. That's a lot. That's 10,000 hours. I ran that number, and I went back and I said, okay, I've been in business since I've been 26. I already got those 10,000 hours in because I adjusted my execution over and over to get closer to my goal, okay? So don't be afraid of the 10,000-hour rule and stay in the game. Please, trust me. Here's the most important thing you're going to walk away from today, and I'm going to test you on it too. The law of diminishing intent. How many today have got a great idea they're going to try to implement? Okay? The law of diminishing intent means that we're going to, okay, it's Good Friday. Our day's over pretty much the rest of the day. We have Easter. We've got Monday. We go into work. What happens? The world gets in front of you and steals it away from you. Your intent. Please don't let that happen here. The law of diminishing intent is that today I'm going to get it started. Tomorrow, the next day comes. It's a week later. It's 2 weeks. It's 3 months. And I'm going to tell you a quick story that I'm not embarrassed about anymore because Maggie's let me not be embarrassed. But I don't know if you guys remember, but the Success Series came to Wisconsin years ago, and we all went to the Bradley Center, and it was full. Schwarzkopf was there. All these people were there, right? And at the back end, they sold us things. Oh, I tell you, I walked out of there like this. Cellophane. And you know what? 3 years later, it went like this to the garbage. Not one of them was opened. And that's perfect. Seriously, I threw it away. Law of diminishing intent. I had great intentions. I never executed. So please, execute something on Monday. You can execute it tomorrow, whatever, but please do that. That's really important. I have a gift for you today. This is my gift to me, my family. They're wonderful. They're tough. Tougher person I know is one in the middle, my wife. We hiked a 14,000-foot peak last summer. She made it, no problem. I mean, it was amazing. But she's also that tough on me. And she's going to watch this video, and she's going to critique it really tough. And she critiqued me tough coming here before that. But what I'm saying is that we all need support. Find it with friends, family, whatever. Maggie, I mean, find a coach. I encourage coaching. My gift to you today, and it's my test today, is I'm going to give you my book for free. Everybody here who wants to get my book signed, I'll sign it, just send me an email, pat@millpm.com. That's my test. It's going to show me if you guys implement, okay? And that's one way to get started.
Let me say something.
Maggie.
In his book, he tells you exactly what to do, step by step. And I said to Pat, why did you write it down? This is your business. His response is, no somebody will do it.
I'm sorry, but so true. I had that happen back in 07. I'm dating myself, but in 07, I was in a room of 150 people that paid $3,000 a piece, and I was one of them that paid that kind of money. Out of that 110 people, two did it, and I'm the only one left today that is continuing to follow through with that. Now, that's big money, okay? So that's why I'm not afraid to give out my secrets. I really am not. Because most people won't do it. And you know what? The universe is big. The universe is so big, we're not going to, you know, it's a sharing environment these days. It's sharing, and I like to share that with you because all I care about is your success. That's all that matters. If I get an email from one of you that says, hey, Pat, I implemented the shock and awe package or one of your ideas, and you know what? I made a sale. I'm riding high. I really am because that's all that matters is what happens for you guys. Because trust me, what I'm doing today is just solidifying what I do every day and what I need to do. So on Monday, I mean, I'm going to be back at it, making calls, closing deals, coming up with a better shock and awe package. But it's just, so I gave you the secrets. It's just a matter of all, and I can't make you guys do anything, but I can encourage you. And I really do. And I also want to encourage you to stay in touch with me if you want and have any questions. I gave you a sheet that asks some hard questions. It's not, I'm not selling you anything here, but go through those questions and answer them. Just answer a couple of them, and you may, it may be tough to look in the mirror, but please do. And if you have any questions, please email me, because I'd be more than happy to answer anything you have, because your success is my success. So, did anybody have any questions?
Jim Rome, who's pushing this stuff, though? I had his brother gave us a set of his tapes years ago, and had some excellent stuff on there.
Yeah.
Never really heard much about him at the time. And now, all of a sudden, I'm getting emails pushing Jim Rome stuff. He died a year and a half ago.
Yeah, he did. And you know what? There was a big push. And some of his stuff is still only on, like, you can't get it on even CDs. It's still on tapes. But I don't know who's pushing them anymore. But we all know Jim Rohn, so, I mean, it's really cool. Yes?
Do you always use the same box, or could you use a different box, different shape, different size, just the point that you're having it delivered?
Having it delivered is one. The big thing is delivered. And two, if you notice that this has, I realized one day when I went into someone's office, it was piled full of stuff. You couldn't see my name, but now you can. You see what I'm saying? Is that I kept improving. But you're right. It doesn't have to be, I mean, I've even encouraged, if anything, you can send something like this. Now, the post office, they will tell, hey, Pat, we got to charge you express. I go, no, wait a minute. This is first class. Trust me. And if anybody wants these, I'll turn you on to where to get them. But these get open, too. Okay, it's something special. I'm in marketing. Rob can attest to that. Do something a little bit different. But yes, anything the FedEx guy delivers has a sense of urgency. So trust me, that investment of $10 could easily transfer for you guys for hundreds of dollars. So it's well worth it.
Could we see your shock and awe packages? Could you open it for us to just look through? Would you mind doing that?
Oh, yeah, I'll leave these out and you guys can page through them. I have some of them for mine. The other thing, just real quickly, on the inside of the box lid, another reason we put our name on the inside of the box lid. Just little things that, you know, you always get in front of people. It's all about marketing. Personally, I'm not into pens and so on, but I've changed my mind on them because, you know what, you name, anytime your name is somewhere, people are going to think about you. The other thing is, when was the last time you wrote a thank you? Wrote a handwritten thank you to a client. And does it work? You know, so I encourage that. Handwrite the old, and you know what I do is I send a notepad with a thank you written in one of these things in the mail for a buck. And people are like, I get thank yous. Rob.
I
got to
ask, what size t-shirt did you send?
Yeah.
We had like a double X. A couple of double X's gone.
How do you know? I mean, if you can insult somebody if you sent one to the
And some of this list was people they knew. That's why. If it was me, I would send large and extra large and so what, right? Because if someone calls you up and says, hey, my t-shirt's wrong size, they called me. I'm going to sell them. And if I send a baby shirt, I'm going to get a call that's going to say, wait a minute, it's the wrong size. Now, you know the old trick that, you know, you send your kid a letter in the mail and you say, oh, it closes, you know, $20 or $50, but you forget to put the money in to get them to call you. Hey, Dad, you forgot to send the money. So it's trust me, it's just about, it's about psychology and using. One more thing before I forget, and this goes back to Lucas. Social media is a popularity contest. Gary Vee told me it's what it is, a popularity contest, and we want to get on top. Why do you think Facebook has been so successful, as much as we may hate it? So trust me, if we can take the strength and all the great stuff that Lucas gave us today to what I did, showed you today on converting, we're all going to be on the road to success. Thank you. You know, I can set something up for $100, I'll be honest with you. I mean, it's a matter of what your return on investment is. So if you have a value of a client of $100 and we've got $20 to work with, we can make something work. See, the one thing to remember is that I'm a printer, so by trade, I get my stuff wholesale. So to me, my costs are a lot less. However, it's about the box, the sense of urgency. And the other thing that you want to do is urgency and scarcity. Now, when I also talk to these people, I tell them two things. I'm going to reserve your zip code, the dentist. I'm going to reserve your zip code for 7 days. No one else can get it, but 7 days. Okay? Does it work? Sometimes. But I'm just saying, that's my scarcity. So that's something that in your world you can create, because scarcity truly works. And that's, you know, all of a sudden, that if there's two people bidding on something, there's scarcity, it raises the price. So the other thing I want to tell you is raise your prices, if you can. Any other questions? Thank you.